Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we're going to look into the future of Power BI. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, the future, how do we even do that? We've talked about it a lot of times on Guy in a Cube videos and our live streams. By the way, if you're not checking out our live streams, Saturday mornings, 9:30 a.m. Central on this channel. So be sure to hang out, ask some questions. We answer some questions. It's a great time. The thing we call out every once in a while is the Power BI release plan. This is the official roadmap from Microsoft of what's going to be coming down the road for Power BI. And they just released the new 2021 Wave 2 information. So I just wanted to call this out, bring your attention to it. But I want to also highlight a few things in there that are coming that I'm very excited about. So the first one is going to be long-term historical data, as well as near real-time performance information that is collected inside of Power BI. This is the log analytics item and just updates coming for log analytics. You may have seen the video that I did not too long ago about log analytics. So if not, go check that out. I mentioned that it's just the AS trace information. And so this item is just talking about the future improvements of it. So premium capacity metrics, some of the usage information like audit log. So those are things that are going to be rolling out. So that's what this item is covering. And I'm definitely excited to see those items come about and just improve the diagnostic information that's available through log analytics. The next item is just improvements to export to Excel. This item was actually called out as an item that came out of the ideas.powerbi.com site. Ideas is where you can go to vote up an item and give your feedback to the product team. This item is a direct result of that. And so what this improvement is going to do is when you export to Excel from a Power BI report for tables and matrices, it's going to actually retain the format, which is insane, right? So now instead of just the flat list, you're actually going to get the formatting that you wanted. Keep your eye on this. There's probably going to be some limitations. So I don't know that it's going to match everything. I had this in the past with paginated reports where the color palette didn't match the Excel color palette. So there's going to be some nuances there, but I'm definitely excited about this. Another item I saw that I was interested in is Power BI's integration with PowerPoint. So for those that go way back into the PowerView days and the ability to actually integrate with PowerPoint there, that was amazing. A lot of people loved it, just interacting reports inside of PowerPoint. This is going to be coming back again. It doesn't actually give a screenshot. It talks about just an actual entire report page or the ability for a given bookmark. So I don't know that it's individual visuals. We'll have to wait and see. It sounds like it's just the report page on a PowerPoint slide, allowing you to interact with that report as you're doing your presentation. So even that is amazing, right? It's better than what we have today. And maybe with Power BI in PowerPoint, it'll cause a separation in the word PowerPoint to bring the space there. Who knows? Another item, I saw this and I was like, oh man, so many people have been asking for this. Artifact level access in Power BI apps. And you may be going like, what does that mean? What this is the ability to actually provide access to individual items inside of the app. The challenge today is apps are one-to-one with a workspace and it's just all or nothing. If you want to provide different roles or different experiences there, you have to have different workspaces and potentially duplicating some sort of content, whether it be the reports, the data sets, whatever. And so what this allows you to do, or what I'm hoping it will really allow you to do, is inside of that app, be able to provide individual access for the items inside of the app, which means you can now have different experiences for different roles. And when I say roles, it's not like a defined role, but think of like a security group or individuals that you want to assign, say like, hey, maybe the executive leadership team sees these reports, then everyone else sees these reports. So you can separate those out and have a different experiences in one app. That's bananas. The last thing I want to leave you with is I've got to go to my computer for this. So let's do what? Head over to my machine. So I'll have a link in the description below, but this is a report that Alex Powers put together. And this is a report where you can just go explore and see like what's coming out. And you can actually search for features that came out in previous months. And you can see public preview versus general availability with links out to the actual release plan itself. This is a great report to have if you want to just keep track on what's going on. Down below, you can view public preview, general availability, or release. The short link is there down below. Go check it out. It was refreshed published as of July 16th, 2021. Kudos to Alex Powers for putting that together and maintaining it. It is a great resource for the community. All right, I want to hand this over to you. If you took time to look at that release plan, what's your favorite item? Let me know down in the comments below. What are you looking forward to? Also, just a call out, there's probably more items that are going to get updated here as we get closer to October, which is the end of the current semester. So keep your eyes out on that as well. But let me know what you think down in the comments below. Would love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.